What's up, everybody? Welcome to Indie Developer Spotlight, the series where I shine a light on the tiniest of developers that send me their works. Their games don't necessarily need to be finished, but there has to be enough of a concept for me to talk about. This is only like a one-time thing for a game. I won't talk any more about it unless there's, you know, demand for it or there's progress being made. So for today's game, we're going to be talking about Breach. Breach is not your average tactical shooter. Breach is a tactical SWAT game using the ROBLOX engine, in case you couldn't tell. It takes heavy influence from SWAT 4. The developer was quoted as saying, "It has been my goal to bring a tactical experience to this platform. ROBLOX is known to be cringy and terrible, yet it has quite the versatile engine. The engine is a private framework style engine shared between him and his friends. It'll be completely different later on. Later on down the line, the game will include these functions that aren't currently in the game at the moment. Flashlights, handcuffs, speedcuffs, tasers, shotguns, beanbag shotty, battering ram, with one of the most realistic optic systems on Roblox using the red dot scope that could actually give you a big one up over your enemy. Headshots are beneficial, as the bullet velocity or type determine the base damage output, i.e. 7.62 does more suppression and base damage, while 5.56 has more penetration by being faster. The game will be scenario based, with different buildings or objective locations. You must enter and safely control the situation. Missions aren't just bound to MetroSWAT, they can also feature something like FBI, HRT, Canadian, JTF2, or British SAS. Some scenarios could have a story. If you listen and pay attention enough, it could really shed some light on the situation to really understand what may have gone down before the call.
So when the developer talked to me about this, I kind of laughed, but then I had that moment of, oh, you're serious. Then he sent me the gameplay footage and I was just like, oh, this is actually kind of cool. An almost Minecraft-like tactical shooter. I can dig it. I can get behind this. So let's talk about the features that are going to be included. Obviously, this game is going to feature customization. I believe you can only pick a primary and a sidearm, but they're going to have a variety of weapons that you can choose from. The weapons will have attachments that you can put onto them. As I said in the beginning, there's going to be several optics. There's also going to be attachments that'll help the weapon to muffle the sound or help the accuracy. You could also choose what type of grenade that you want. I'm guessing they're going to make it so that you can actually choose the type of armor that you want to wear. Although I'm not sure if they're going to be using the same model that they did with SWAT 4, where anything that you have can make it so that you walk a little slower because of how much weight you're putting on. I'm not sure if that's a thing. If the developer wants to answer that one down in the comments, I'll just pin it to the top. The one thing that's really impressed me so far about this game is the echo sounds that are going to be featured. Just watch this clip, it's actually pretty neat. The game is going to feature a damage system. If you are shot in the leg, you won't die instantly. If you're shot in the arm, again, you won't die instantly. If you're shot in the chest without any armor on, if you're shot in the lower torso, if you're shot in the head, the head seems to have more damage than most parts of the body. High velocity damages can really fling the body. There's also going to be a shield in the game. Looks like there's going to be a ricochet effect. Yeah, the game is going to feature bullet ballistics, where the bullets are basically going to be realistic, you know, doing ricochets or falling down to the ground. But yeah, what are your guys' thoughts on Breach? Is this something that interests you? Do you not care? Be honest, because feedback is always good. Honestly, I think it's kind of a neat idea, but we'll just have to see how it goes. All right, well, I want to thank everybody for coming out to watch, and I guess I'll catch you in the next one. Bye-bye.